Hey, what's going on, everybody? Whit and Kerry Hyam here. And first off, I want to ask you guys a question. Where do you think your biggest mindset, woes are happening right now inside your business? What are you currently struggling with between your ears? Mm-hmm. Because what we're going to be talking about today is three major mindset gaps that are possibly holding you back in your business. And I would say probably maybe even for the majority of people, are holding them back in some way.
Destroying their progress.
Destroying their business. And if you guys can learn these things and be aware of these things, what this is going to help you do is become more aware of your customers, which is, and not only more aware of your customers, but also more aware of yourself and how you're holding yourself back from generating leads and sales. And so what this is going to help you do, if you can identify these three things, is help you generate more leads and sales, because your own, the 6 inches between your brain or in between your ears, are not holding you back in your business. And so
it's where it all starts, yep. Guys.
And so this is going to help here. It's going to help you identify major pitfalls that me and Kerry have seen other people do. So we're going to help
we've
you try
even
to
made ourselves.
And we've even made these. Okay. So for those of you who are going to be jumping on with us right now, comment who you are, where you're from. Let us know where you're coming in from. So that way we can acknowledge you guys as you're jumping on here. Jan.
Hey, Jan. Welcome.
Awesome to
and
have you.
In case we're meeting for the first time, this is Whit and I'm Kerry, and we're Invictus members here inside of Elite Marketing Pro. And it's Daily Dose of Awesome time. So comment your name, where you're from. That way we can give you a shout out.
Yes. And also, if you're not watching this and it's not live, just comment replay. Let us know. That way we know that you guys are jumping on this, but we want to let everybody know, whether you're a big commenter or just like to hit the like button. We absolutely love the people here in this community, mm-hmm. but let's dive into the three major blind spots that I think people have in their business that are actually holding them back. And guys, this is totally the space between your ears that do this. And I see this on a daily, we see this on a daily basis in a lot of people, and we don't even recognize that we're doing it. Okay. That we actually have the problem and not somebody else. Okay. So Kim, welcome.
Ray,
Chuck, Ray. Awesome.
Jan. Cool. Awesome. Cool. As you're hopping on, comment your name, where you're from. Let us give you a shout out.
Okay.
All right?
And we're going to have a story that goes along with each of these. And we're going to move quickly through this story. But me and Kerry had a personal experience this last week. So
last week, as we were at the Fast Track Workshop in LA.
So as we were spending our time not only learning, but helping other people grow past their own mindset gaps and really step into their business and take ownership of their business. So we're spending a lot of time helping other people. And we get this email from a lady that had watched one of our webinars that me and Kerry did. And we're actually going to read you the email.
Let me first pre-frame, okay? Yeah. So the webinar that we have going, it's a recording, right? Yes. It's all automated. It's all evergreen. And we actually have a video at the beginning of the webinar that says, hey,
this
we're so grateful you're here. This is a recording of a training that we did previously.
Like months ago.
Months ago. If you have questions as you're going through this recording and through this training, because you won't be able to comment, feel free to shoot us a message on our fan page. Well, instead, we get an
a nasty email. So the first email was kind of nasty, and we just said, look, you're more than welcome to unsubscribe, and you're more than welcome to stop following us. That's totally cool. And we left it at that.
So,
but
I'm just
she had to
leave.
Come back.
So Whit, he actually handled this really well. I was facilitating at the time that all of this was happening, but he handled it very, very well. Usually when we get nasty hate mail, because who here deals with haters?
Yep.
Give us a hashtag haters.
Hashtag haters if you're dealing with it right now.
With haters. Because usually when we get those haters that come in, we just delete them, right?
Just
it's
like,
just, whatever. But she said something that Whit knew he needed to fix something here inside of her head. And I want you guys to listen just to this one little section of the conversation and let me know if you can identify what the mindset gap is, okay? So I told Whit told her it was a recording, right? So that's the reason that you can't comment. And she says, don't feel sorry, I knew it was a recording. Yes, I wasn't sure though how people were commenting in real time to a recording. Okay,
it's
anyways.
It's a recording.
Nobody's anyways.
Commenting in real time.
Anyways, I don't think anyone was engaging with you like you made it seem. Because it was a recording. And I think it's funny how you say you care about my success when you don't even know who I am.
Where's the gap?
Where's the mindset
so
gap?
She is believing that
Brandy.
We cannot care for another person or another person's business without actually knowing them.
Yep.
Where's the mindset gap here, guys? I want you guys to identify that. If you guys can put a label on that mindset gap, what would you call that?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, what would you call that?
Hi,
if you
Angel.
Guys could, I want you guys to drop a comment just down below. Let me know what you would label that as somebody that believes that we cannot help somebody if we do not
Unless
know who
we
they
know
are.
Know who they are.
Okay, if all of you are network marketers, okay, what would you call that?
Let's see.
Okay. Blaming others is easier than accepting responsibility. Okay,
perfect.
I love
Tiny
that phrase.
Minds,
Tiny
Angel.
Minds.
I
love it. I
love it. Yeah.
Yeah.
Brandy.
Yeah, great question. Clueless. Awesome. I love that.
Close.
Immediately, right? Guys, can you hear that in that language? Immediately when she started to watch that.
Self-absorbed.
Right when she started to watch that, immediately it went through my head. She came into this training with a closed mindset of, oh, this is somebody else that just wants to take my money.
Yep.
Okay, and she actually said that to us.
Yep.
You guys don't care.
Small world view.
And so.
So think about this as a network marketer who is trying to build a team of thousands of, hundreds of thousands of people.
Of open like-minded people.
And a team of hundreds of thousands of people. First of all, do you think she can attract the people that she's looking for? Those open, like-minded people.
The way that she is right now, can she attract those people?
Second, how does she expect to bless hundreds of thousands of people's lives? Because guess what? Chances are she's not going to know who those people are. Right?
Just sorry, but businesses get big. She will attract who she is.
No,
exactly.
She can't, right,
Jan?
She cannot. She has to fix what's up here first, okay? And so it actually, went very, very patiently.
I was sarcastic.
He was a lot of sarcasm, but also a lot of love when he replied.
I approached this with a lot of care and concern for her, and expressing how much we did care about her, even though we did not know her. Hence, I was even entertaining the thought of emailing her back. I could have just said, "Hell with this! I'm not going to email you back." But I wanted to email her back because I could see a big mindset gap for her and she was never going to get the success that she ever wanted.
No. Nope.
Did I use a lot of sarcasm? Totally, because that's how
that's
I am.
That's the way he is.
But at the same time, I showed a lot of care and concern inside that sarcasm of, look, this is what you need to be focusing on. And immediately, she went back at I got a pound away and I've got to be right. And I'm like, I'm totally cool with that.
He even threw it out. He's like, I'm sure right now, as you are reading this message, you're coming up with a very nasty response.
A very nasty response. I'm rubber, you're glue. And this is going to go back and forth for the next week.
But he just said, we wish you the best in your business. Yep. And if you want to attract a team of hundreds of thousands of people, you need to change your mindset. Because guess what? Chances are you're not going to know who they are.
So moral of the story to this one that we shared, and this was a big one for us.
Hashtag higher frequency.
Yes,
I love it, Ray.
Keep that. The moral of the story here is guys, when you're in your business, you're going to go through some steps where you're going to all of a sudden start to have that negative feeling. Guys, we've all had it. We have all had the negative feeling come up like, oh man, and we're going to go over a couple more scenarios that is going to set you guys, because you always hear the thing like, oh, I'm going a couple steps forward and then one step back, couple step forward, one step back. And a lot of the times, and in a few more of these things that we're going to share, these gaps, you're actually taking thousands of steps backwards and only moving one step forward. And this is how powerful this is and how you need to be aware of it. But moral of the story is when you're looking at training and you're looking at mentorship, you better be coming into it in a mindset that I am completely open, that this is going to take time, that whatever happens, good or bad, it's part of my learning curve that I've got to go through, because that's what she's experiencing right now, is that she has maybe looked at other people and watched other trainings and she's like, oh, this is how I'm not going to do it or whatever. That mindset will always keep her.
The people who she's hopping on their trainings are the ones that are impacting millions of people's lives.
Yeah, exactly. And I actually said that to her in the email. I said, I want to thank you so much because you just gave me content ideas for over 100,000 people that I can impact right now.
Yep.
Because this is where it starts, guys.
Give me a hashtag content.
Yep, hashtag content in the comments. Right now. Okay.
And that moves us on to the second mindset gap that we're going to be talking about. And this is actually from someone who just went VIP here inside the community. She's a freaking rock star.
Yes.
She is.
And this is a great learning.
This is a great learning.
So learning. If she catches this is not a throw at you or anything like that. This is great, great.
And I actually helped her. I actually did help her. And I'll actually tell you what I responded to her. But she shot me a message and she said, "I'm so excited I'm now a VIP member. I'm scared and extremely excited at the same time. Honestly, I'm more scared of not understanding the process and failing than I am about losing money at this point. I just want to win. I want to be a testimony, and I want to pay it forward and help people." So she has the right mindset, right?
But what did she lead with?
Hang on, we're not done yet.
Okay, and I'm going to ask that question because I want you guys to identify that. What did she lead with first? Okay, so she got into the whole detail of, "I want to help people," but what did she lead with first? Okay, keep going.
Next. "While I can feel freedom tugging at me now, the small voice is still there. What if this is just another system that will fail me? Anyway, I have a few questions." And then she went on to just a few questions about the process of getting started as a VIP.
Okay, so failure is what she does. "I was wondering because I'm still new and it's going to take time, but my
normal life is not so well right now. And trying not to be negative." Hey, any suggestions?
I get it. That's being aware of that.
She led with being afraid to fail.
Afraid to fail. But what do we call that? What's another word for that? A four-letter word. What do we call that? Immediately, that's what you're leading off with. What is it called? Four-letter word. Really easy. We use it all the time. It's the opposite of...
Already placing self-doubt. Okay. Exactly.
It's already placing self-doubt. Mm-hmm. But what do we call that? What's that four-letter word that everybody gets scared of? What's another word for scared?
Fear. Got it. Yay.
Thank you. Guys, fear is not real. You are imagining something happening. Fear is not real. Okay? The reason fear is real inside of us, even though it's not real, is because we make it real. That's the crappy thing about fear. And that's what is being led with is fear, the unknown, something that we don't even know is going to happen yet. Even if
future events appearing real.
Future events appearing real.
It hasn't even happened yet. Yes. And here are in the words that she was uttering saying, "What if this is just another system that will fail me?" What is she putting back into her mind when she says that?
She's giving herself there. Okay.
False evidence appearing real. That's another way of saying it. I love saying future events, though, because your mind is
giving you a future scenario
that hasn't happened yet.
Okay? Mm-hmm. So our brain is basically trying to predict the future to keep us safe, and it doesn't work because we don't know if it's going to happen yet. We can only impact what we're doing right now, not in the future, right now. Okay? Yeah. So you want to be focusing on that. And this is a great thing.
And my response to her was, tell that little voice telling you to take a hike.
Take a hike.
Right? Get out of here. And the thing is I love what J.T. DeBolt says. He says, you know, most people believe that the eyes are the window to the soul. I know a lot of people that can lie to you, looking you straight in the eye,
and be very good at it.
However, there are... You can identify a person's soul and their intentions and who they are as a human being by the words that they use.
Yes.
Right? So the quickest way to change into what did we call it at the workshop? To back whatever it's called.
Oh, yeah. I can't remember.
The quickest way to changing here is by actually...
Backdraft, whatever you want to call it.
The easiest way to change what's in your mind is to utter words... That you want, right?
I love this. Hashtag power of now. Exactly. Because it is the power of now.
It is.
And what you can change.
So when you have those thoughts of doubt telling you, oh my goodness, what if this is just another system that will fail me? Oh my gosh, I've been putting all of this time into all these different things. I failed so many times before.
Or for example, you know, family life where family life right now at home is not negative. And that was commented earlier. What tips do you have? Guys, you need to identify the positive things that are happening, okay? Mm-hmm. Because when negative happens, guess what overwhelms the positive? The negative, because our brain is so easily focused on it to keep us safe that we focus on the negative.
Yep.
So what you need to be asking yourself in those situations where you feel overwhelmed with negativity and you're trying try not, and you're trying to stay positive, identify three positive things that are working for you on a daily basis. Mm-hmm. Identify three positive things that are working in your business.
And it's all based off of externally verifiable evidence, right? Yes. Things that you can actually see, and you can say, based off of this, this is working.
Yes.
You know, if it's your ad, what are your metrics? Yep. Right? Maybe even the positive thing that's happening is that you even did an ad, right? That's a positive, because there's people that are struggling right now in their businesses that don't even know Facebook ads.
Yes.
You are so much further ahead than where you are. So set yourself up by success by those positive affirmations saying, I got this.
Yep.
Right? And yeah, I may have failed at a couple things before, but now based off of those experiences, I know what I need to do to make this work.
Yep. So, Brian, you know, self-talk, absolutely.
Yes.
But we want to make this external, okay? Mm-hmm. Not just this self-talk of absorbing yourself inside yourself and then just trying to talk yourself through. We want to get this external. So like Carrie is talking about, externally verifiable things that are positive happening right now in your life that you can identify, that you can actually physically attach yourself to and be that way. Okay.
I got this shit.
Yeah,
I love it, Angel.
Yes, you
do. Got this.
Okay,
I've
next.
Got it. Okay, next is actually something that happened at a Fast Track event two workshops ago.
Yes.
Where were we in? We were in Chicago.
I wasn't at this one.
We
but
were
I know
in
this
Chicago.
One.
So this was actually a Fast Track member, and I absolutely love her. If she's watching,
we love everybody
this,
that we're talking
love,
about.
We
all
love
this.
Every
okay, this
single
is, again,
person
don't
that
throw at you guys
about.
Of, oh, you. No, this is all about love and concern.
And it's also about helping other people identify some of these mindset gaps that they have. Just like Whit and I helped these certain people through these things, we now want to use that as a way for you brand new people here inside the community to not make the same mistakes or not have the same gap. Because it's not a mistake. It's just a gap of what you've been rewired with, right? You're rewiring your mind right now. So it was at a Fast Track event in Chicago. Absolutely love this individual. She's amazing. She's doing, like, seriously kicking butt inside of her business right now. And she was talking, she was sharing with the room about how in one of her ads that she had going, she had put the emoji right next to the link. And when you do that, your link is all of a sudden invalid because when you click on it in the URL, your URL doesn't recognize an emoji, right? And so she's all like, we had this running forever, and all of a sudden I'm going in and people are saying, hey, your link's not working. And it had been running for a week. And I was just like, we're so stupid. How did we not even check our link?
Guys, are you listening to her tone as she's saying this? What is she doing?
That's exactly how I was channeling my inner version of this person.
So
right?
guys, as you're talking to yourselves, how do you guys talk to yourselves as well? Like, or when you're like sitting in front of a coach or you're learning something and you're like, oh, you know, and you get that tone and it's raised and you start to, oh, this and that, this isn't working, this.
Emotion, right?
That's
loading
all
emotion.
It is. That is all Carrie just did right there is she led with emotion. And what does that do? You are not evaluating what's working and what's
not
working.
And the thing is she had amazing things happening in her business.
Yes.
She really did. But she had made this mistake. And then the first thing that she said was, gosh, I'm so stupid.
What happened?
Right?
What? So this is what I was talking about earlier, guys. As I was talking about, we feel like we take two steps forward, one step back,
hey,
two
Alan.
Steps forward, one step back. What happened right there when they say, I am so stupid? How many steps back do you really take when you tell yourself that, or you get stuck right there telling yourself that you're stupid because you made a mistake? Guys, I still make mistakes in my ads all the time.
Yeah.
And
he's the traffic coach.
Yeah, I mean, I do it all the time.
Right?
Okay. But what happened? She took 1,000 steps back and now she's trying to work herself forward again.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. It's just exactly destruction is a great way to put it.
You are learning, right? You're the student. Think of yourself as
student.
That little. Think of yourself as a
We're
little second grader.
Students.
We're students, right? And the thing is yes, Katrina, mistakes are inevitable when you're learning, right?
I just wait until
falling on your face is inevitable.
Just wait until you get into more of the technology stuff and stuff like that. It's going to happen. It's a pain in the butt, but The point is to always to identify the things that are working right now in your business. I don't care if you're not producing leads. I don't care if you're not producing sales. Guys, that is not the point. The whole point with you of being a part of a system is learn how to network and grow an audience.
Yep. And so how I...
That's the point.
How I helped this individual, because we told you how we were going to help you overcome these major mindset gaps. What I did with this individual, first of all, I led with care and concern, and I actually got very upset because of how she was talking to herself. And I asked this person, I was like, how are you talking to yourself right now? And it got her in the present. And she said, not the way that I would want my children to talk to themselves. Right. And all of a sudden, and so then I asked, great. Okay. So you made a mistake. Oh, well, it's in the past. It happened. Right.
In the past, right?
In the past. Now, what are three things that are working in your business right now?
And she identified them.
And she identified what those three things were.
And then I guarantee they asked, well, what are a couple things that aren't? And then what might we do differently?
And what might we
do differently? Guys, this is about evaluating yourself. And again, like I said, I don't care if no leads, if you're like, oh man, I've been at this for a while, I don't got any leads in sales. Mm-hmm. Guys, I guarantee if I sat down with you in a 30-minute session, I would identify three amazing things that are happening in your business. Because I hear it all the time, nothing's working. Really? Nothing is working.
Nothing?
Absolutely nothing is working. The only way that is possible if you were doing nothing. Mm-hmm. That is the only way that nothing is working is if you're actually physically not applying anything. But if you're at least attempting to apply things, I could easily identify three things that are working in your business.
Yeah.
Now, you might not feel like, oh, well, that doesn't matter because I haven't made money. Or I haven't generated leads, or I haven't gotten sales in my network marketing business. Guys, you're missing the point of this. In order to get the leads and sales, you've got to fix right here to attract that to happen. Okay, to make that happen, to actually find the people that are gonna make that happen.
Yep.
That is the three mind gaps that everybody is missing right now. Even me and Carrie included, we go through the same thing. We do. We go through the same thing all the time where we catch ourselves. Like, you would not believe how many times I have to stop Carrie. I do this too. But
I am naturally a person that wears my heart on my sleeve.
Totally.
I'm naturally an emotional human being and I absorb emotions that are around me. And so it's very easy for me to load emotion before information.
Yes.
Very easy.
Yeah.
I've gotten much better I cannot thank the Fast Track program enough for that.
Yep.
For some of the tools that we have learned.
Yes.
Quick little, you know, blip to them because absolutely
it works.
The Fast Track program that I've been able to become an evaluating individual.
Yep. Where she was more of a judgmental person on her part, not to other people, but on her part.
On myself. I'm my worst enemy, right? And how many other people have that right now inside the community? How many of you judge yourself and hold yourself at a higher standard than you would hold other people?
Yep.
Because that is a huge mindset gap for me and something that I had to overcome inside of my journey.
Yep.
Was realizing that I am a student, that I am learning,
yep,
and that I am not put on a pedestal, right? Like, I cannot put myself above other people. I can't say, oh, it's okay that they're only right here because I should be right here.
Yep.
That's another mindset gap. There's four mindset gaps that we've given you on this, right?
And my worth, exactly, guys. And guys, and this is something that you've got to get good at and identifying when you're in that. Because this is the thing, when you're stuck in there and you're leading with emotion, guess what emotion does? Is it keeps you stuck there because it's a pride thing. Mm-hmm. All of a sudden, pride comes in, a whole bunch of different
ego.
Other emotions. Yep, exactly. Ego comes in because you want to be right and you want to say somebody else is wrong. That's usually what it comes down to. Well, I'm right, you're wrong. And that's what happened in that email. Okay. The problem is I'm not the one stuck. That first email that we wrote, guess who's not stuck? Me. I'm still moving forward in my business where she is so focused on proving somebody else wrong that she is now physically stuck because she's emotional about it.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And so again, guys, how many of you right now running ads or been running ads for a long time and you've gotten a lot of advice and all of a sudden you're stuck and you're like, well, nothing's working for me right now.
Katrina,
I
don't want you to think that emotions are bad.
No, I don't want you to think
emotions,
that at all.
Emotions are what makes us human beings,
yep, totally.
Right? It's okay to have emotions. However, when it comes to evaluating what's working and when it comes to progressing, the only way you can be in evaluation is if You
recognize that emotion.
Recognize emotion and load information, right? You take information and look at the information, what's externally verifiable, and leave emotion out of it.
Yep. Yep, because emotion's going to happen. That's a natural part of your makeup.
They're good.
Okay, there is no way that you're not going to feel emotion with anything, but it's identifying that and saying, okay, am I judging right now or am I actually evaluating myself?
Yep.
Okay, and so that's the thing that I'm talking about, guys, is get in that evaluative state. If you're looking for the easy way to do this, what are three things that are working right now in your business? And if you tell me nothing, I will prove you wrong. Okay? Like, and I will, because I know I can sit down inside somebody's business and find three things that are working.
Yep.
I don't care if you've done one thing so far. In that one thing, I can find three things. Guys, it's just the way it is because you took action. So, three things that are working, two things that are not, and what might I do differently? Get in that evaluative state. Let's fix between here and start attracting those things.
Okay.
So right now, if you feel like you're that person that's just like, oh, I've done all this stuff and nothing's working, step back and take a look at yourself without emotion. Drop the emotion and say, okay, am I actually evaluating or am I just wanting to prove somebody else wrong because something hasn't worked for me? Okay, like an old past system. Okay, that's in a judgment state of saying, oh, that system didn't work for me. Well, maybe it would have worked for you, maybe if there were some other things in place. Okay, or maybe those other systems led you to the system that you need to be a part of right now.
Yep.
Okay, this is all evaluative. Okay, getting out of the judgment state and getting to the evaluative state. Mm-hmm. So hopefully you guys got some value out of this. If you guys got any value out of it, just drop a comment, # value. I know we probably went over. Me and Carrie always do. We get on our soapbox.
We get excited.
But, yeah. But anyways, guys, if you guys got value out of this, just comment # value. Let us know. And then start applying this today. And what I want you guys to do today, if you guys are cool with this, is I want you to go to the Elite Marketing Pro community, the community that you're in right now, and I want everybody that's on this live, if you feel comfortable doing this, to comment three things that are working for you right now in your business.
Yep.
I want you guys to do that, seriously. And if you guys want to tag me and Carrie in this,
please do.
Please tag us.
Please do.
Okay, tag us as soon as you can in this, because
there
I want to...
There are three things that are working, and it three can things that be are working. As simple as... I did a Facebook Live.
Or I did an ad. I did a post today.
I did a post today.
Something
right?
that probably got you outside your comfort zone, mm-hmm. right? Okay. And then tag me and Carrie in it. We're totally cool with that. Okay. I hope that by the end of the day, we have hundreds of people tagging us
yep.
in that and saying, yes, I did it. Yes, I did it. These are three things. I want you guys to do that. You guys cool with that? If you're cool with that, give me the thumbs up emoji and
let us know
and tag me and Carrie in that.
Yep. But, and also remember that it's almost, you know, Excuses Summit time.
Yes.
So if you have not gotten your tickets for No Excuses Summit.
And you're sitting on the fence.
Make just sure you get
imagine me right now pushing you off of the fence onto the other side. And I don't care if you land on your head, but I'm pushing you off the fence and you're landing on the side to go to No Excuses. Okay?
Yep.
That's what Witt's doing, is running at you, pushing you off the fence, and you're coming to No Excuses with us.
So yeah. Funny visual.
Yeah, so that's what's happening. But no, if you guys can make it, definitely
awesome.
Make it. But
okay,
guys,
awesome. We're looking forward to seeing those posts of what's working inside of your business.
Over here. You look like you're off the screen.
Give me another # value, and we will Daily Dose of Awesome will be live again here inside the community on Monday.
Yes.
Okay?
So everybody have a great rest of your day, great weekend, and for those of you that are celebrating the Memorial Day, be safe, please.
Yes.
Be safe.
Be safe.
Love you guys.
See ya.